What's up, YouTube? I'm Not Your Average Joe, and welcome back to my channel and my first episode of
Is This Really a podcast?
The podcast where I have a guest and we talk about whatever we want to for 10 unedited minutes. My guest today is Tracy Dias, the only YouTuber to ever let me on her channel. Without any more pots and pans, let's get started. Okay, I wanted to talk about whatever celebrities you've seen in person, not in like a concert setting. Like, have you ever run into any celebrities on the streets, like minor celebrities, major celebrities?
Major celebrities?
Right, like have you ever been like walking down the street and you're like, oh, there's like, like Diplo or Pitbull?
I really can't even say, no. Except for that one experience I had with, what's his face? He's not even big anymore though.
Kevin Rudolph, Kings of Leon.
He's like an R&B singer from like the 2000s.
You don't know his name.
Can I look at it? I can't think of it on the top of my head.
Okay, well that's fine. I mean, okay, so the reason why, okay, I kind of want to talk about my experience, which is why I chose the topic. but the place, if you want to see a lot of celebrities, especially in like England, is the London Heathrow Airport. So I was getting a connection flight to Vienna, Austria. And we see somebody walking and they're like surrounded by blue bodyguards and it's Emma Watson. So, and we were going through security and somebody took a picture and one of her bodyguards walked over and they were like, give me your camera, you can't have that. So she took the camera, deleted the picture, handed it back to him and goes, thank you.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so that's that experience, so yeah.
Have you ran into a lot? Like,
no. But
I feel really lame. I really can't think of anyone I've ever ran into, but like big names.
The same day, do you know Helen? I don't. I'm not gonna say her name, but Helena Bonham Carter, married to Tim Burton, Bellatrix Lestrange from Harry Potter.
Vaguely.
If I showed you a picture,
probably.
You'd know
I'm
who
so
she
bad.
Is. Okay. Okay. Apparently, she was in the same airport at the same time. And like she wasn't in character, she was just dressed as she normally would be, but she was like in a top hat and like her hair was crazy and she was wearing like a matting coat that like went to her knees and like black leather boots. Which I was like, you're definitely married to Tim Burton. Like
dang.
Not even funny. But
oh, I wish I could add to this.
I thought it would be an interesting topic. Okay,
this is why you need to tell me.
I do need to tell you before. I thought it would surprise on you. Okay. Best concert experience then.
I just got back from Rolling Loud, so like that was like the best thing of my life.
What is Rolling Loud? Is it like Coachella but for
like hip hop and rap? Yeah.
Not millennials.
It is for millennials. What the heck? If you're into hip hop and rap, you probably know what Rolling Loud is. But yeah.
I mean, I knew all the stars from your Snapchat, like who you were talking about and stuff. But like,
yeah, it's literally just like a whole music festival just full of like hip hop and rap. So like I'm really into that, so I was like in heaven, like everywhere.
So question, is there more weed at Coachella or Rolling Loud?
Probably Rolling Loud. Considering the name. Like I think people literally thought I was like a druggie or something. It's
just because you were there.
Because like, yes, like I literally didn't even do anything really like this weekend, but I kept getting asked. I literally got DM'd. Someone slid in my DM and was like, I see you're at Rolling Loud. Do you need any LSD, like shrooms, any? I was like, no.
It's not organic.
I'm so confused. I was like, what? Yeah, that was crazy. But yeah, everybody kept coming up to me like, do you have like blunt to buy off you? I'm like, no. Sorry. What do I look like?
You had a birthday recently too, right?
Yes, I'm 21.
So, we have a little bottle of babies. We've had a couple birthdays in the house recently. So, for the rest of the podcast, you get, does that say 12 or 21?
I don't know.
Right?
I feel like
it says 21. 21. It says 21. So, exactly. We have our sangria. Cheers.
I can drink that.
Exactly. Legally.
Legally. There's drinking.
I mean, it's college, so.
I know.
Yeah. What is a crazy vacation story?
Crazy vacation story.
Or, like, interesting.
I want to say I almost got like attacked by a shark 2 summers ago. I swear to God.
No, I believe you. My eyes are raised in surprise.
I swear. honestly, I still don't really know, but I swear.
When, where, why, how, who?
2 years ago.
Were you in a cage?
No. I was literally just in the water, in the ocean. It was so scary. But, no, 2 years ago, I want to say. Yeah, freshman, like freshman summer.
Fresh, okay.
I went on a beach trip with Maddie, Indy, Kate, like literally right. my sweet mates from the freshman year. And yeah, we went to the beach, we all got in the water, and they're all like, oh, let's go paddle. And I'm kind of looking back like, you know, this is getting a little too
that's
far.
That's where sharks
like,
feed.
I can swim and everything, but like, it's not, but like, I'm not gonna like back out. Right. So I was like, okay, let's do it. Everybody's going, peer pressure, college, you know. But yeah, they're like, let's go. And I'm like, okay, fine, let's go. And like, we're going. And then all of a sudden we're like, literally, I can't feel the ground anymore. We're like swimming and like, I turn back and I'm like, the shore is way over there. And I'm just like, wow, we're really far. And then of course, I forget who said it, but somebody's like, you know, like, you can tell when like a shark's around when a group of fish like jump out of water. Literally like a minute later, a whole like group of fish like flip out, like we're like here and it's like happened like right over there, and I lost my shit. Like I lost it. I was like,
did you see it?
Oh my god. No, but I wasn't gonna about to risk it. I'm like, I'm
open
not,
your
like,
eyes and you're salt water.
No, I took no chances. I was like, I'm going. And like, so we all like freaked out. And like, I'm honestly not a good friend to have in that situation. Because literally they were low-key in front of me. And I was like, no, like y'all are leaving.
Using that like, pulling ponytail.
Literally, I was pulling them back. I'm the worst in dangerous situations.
Oh,
you will probably
gosh.
Die with me. You don't want to be around me. Cause
no, so now I don't know.
Apparently,
so
I learned that you.
You
will like, I will let you go. Like, I'm not going alone.
That's scary.
And so, yeah, we were like swimming, and then we were with like Maddie's parents, like their beach house, and they were hanging out with us. And then, like, they saw us freaking out. And so they're on the shore, like, oh my god. And we're like screaming shark, and they're screaming like shark. And we're like, oh my god, like, is it actually like a shark?
They see it too.
And we like literally, so we made it, didn't get any of my shark, thank the Lord. But yeah, we get to the shore and they're like, what's wrong? Like,
nothing.
Like, you literally were waving and screaming shark too. I thought you knew. They were like, oh my god, no, we were just trying to figure out what you were saying. And I was like, oh my god, I swear, I believe it is a shark.
What limb could you live without? If a shark were gonna attack you, which limb would you offer?
My left arm.
Your left arm. Are you a righty? Yeah. Okay, that would
be. Are you a left?
No, I was just asking. I don't think like I
want
to
no,
be.
No, I want my right arm, my dominant arm gone.
So you
want
to be like Anna Sophia Robb? The movie at Tunnels Beach. I went there in Hawaii, and the girl gets her arm. Bethany Hamilton.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay,
so
okay,
she lost her arm.
Yeah, I'll lose my left.
Yeah, I don't think you really get a choice. But like in the moment, I'd be like, if you're
if
coming,
I could,
I'll just reach
if it's
out.
Already there, I'm like, here, take this one.
Just be like a crab. Just rip it off and then just hand it to him. That's a little scary. But
no, thank you.
So what do you think is in the ocean we don't know about? Because apparently we know more about space than we do the ocean.
I have heard that.
So what do you think is like in the ocean?
Scary stuff.
Like, cause every time okay.
How do you describe something that you don't even know, you know?
There isn't a way, but every time that I think it's Natural Geographic or whatever, whenever they do a deep dive, they come back with something like anywhere new between 5 to 13 new species of like animals they didn't know, like variations. Like I saw that they did a dive in Antarctica and they thought it would be dead, but there were like starfish, fishfish, jellyfish, squidfish. But
why do you know all these?
Because I spend a lot of time on YouTube and nature.
You just watch
deep diving. I do. They're fascinating. But like, what about like Megalodon? What is that big wormy thing that lives in the water? The old Nessie, Loch Ness monster. Like, do you believe in those kind of things? Like mega species.
Low key, I do. Cause you know why not? I guess. Like, who's to say it's not real? Like,
that's true. Cause we have Do we have more proof than we don't that they exist? So,
actually, no.
Kind of on the same realm, comparing the ocean to space. Topic of aliens.
Aliens. I was like, I see where you're going with this. I see. I 100% believe it. There's 100% like aliens.
Why?
There's no way it can just be us.
That's true.
Like, there's just no way. There's no way, like, Earth and it's humans and, like, that's it. There's, like, nothing else out there.
That's true. No way. That's true. It's infinite.
You know?
Like, yeah, that's true. Well, that was our timer. Thank you so much for watching. Is this really a podcast? I encourage you guys to go check out Tracy's channel. We did a collab. It'll be linked somewhere around the screen. And, yeah, that's the end of the first podcast. Thanks, guys.